we're going to finish Liza's run tomorrow. She didn't get a chance to finish it, and I get choked up thinking about it because so many women have been touched by this.
An 8.2-mile run cut short. Tomorrow morning, though, runners across the country will finish that run for Eliza Fletcher. She's the mother and teacher who was kidnapped and murdered while jogging early in the morning last Friday in Memphis, Tennessee. People here in the Triad are lacing up their sneakers to remember Eliza. Fox 8's Caroline Boyer is live outside the Lululemon store at Friendly Center in Greensboro, where the runners are meeting tomorrow morning. Good evening, Caroline.
Bob, it'll be a 4-mile run that will start at the exact time Eliza was abducted 1 week ago, 5:20 a.m. That's 4:20 Memphis time. This is a story women across the Piedmont Triad tell me hits close to home, even though it happened hundreds of miles away. The Tennessee tragedy is prompting several runners to switch up their habits. That includes carrying pepper spray, not wearing headphones, and making sure someone has their location while jogging. Tomorrow morning, these women are letting go of fear and taking their power back. The Finish Eliza's Run in Greensboro is one of several planned across the country. Michelle Brooks organized the event and is expecting about 100 people to come out. She tells me she normally doesn't follow these stories in the news, but Eliza's stuck with her.
This is truly an incredible story because I think a lot of people can relate to this in the sense that there is a little bit of fear that goes into that. But when there's strength in numbers and there's strength in going and doing these activities with other people, I think that's where we feel our safest. And it was really touching to be able to see this happen, even in the city that I'm in currently. And it's just so heartwarming to be able to see everybody just band together and be able to essentially move mountains together.